Hey guys, I can't remember if I've talked thoroughly about materials or fabric or not, so I thought I'd just make this video just in case. I see a lot of you guys in the class like are flying through it, so it makes me think you already know about it, but I don't want to exclude, you know, the people who don't know about it yet. And so anyways, if this is repetitive, you don't have to watch this video. But anyway, so when you want to add fabric, I definitely recommend doing it before you're fitting, because the fabric is probably going to change the way the fabric drapes on your avatar. So you want to make sure your library is open, and then you can double click on fabric here. And there is a whole library that CLO provides. Again, if you're not seeing it, you might wanna check for this little arrow up here. If there's like a blue N, like how there is on mine, then you probably need to download some stuff. I know my computer is really good about saving space and it moves files to the cloud. So sometimes I even have to go into Finder to re-download them from the cloud. But anyways, if you see that blue thing, click it and it'll re-download it. Right now though, I have a ton of fabrics. I'm pretty good. And you know, they're organized. They have like really great names. So hopefully you can find the kind of fabric you are looking for. If you can't, CLO does have a store that you can download more for free. You can even purchase some, or the department is working on getting equipment to actually input any kind of fabric. So that's really exciting too. So any fabric we have in the classroom, we can digitize it and use it. So I'm looking forward to expanding our library for students to really experiment with different fabrics. So stay tuned for that. I'm working on it. But in the meantime, pick your fabric and it should be added over here in your object browser. You can change the name, you can right click on it and, you know, rename it if you want. If you have one that you really, really like, but you just want to change and add another color, you can just click copy and it'll add it. And then you can change the name as well. To change color, now make sure you don't really want to necessarily click on the pattern to change the color. You actually, like, see how when I click on her pant leg, this pant leg, it still has the first fabric checked under main. It's kind of weird, right? It didn't go to pants. It just doesn't care. It thinks the pattern is selected, the pattern piece. It doesn't even care about the fabric. So under property editor, it's not really showing you anything about the camo fabric. So if you want to click on the camo fabric, you have to actually click on it in the object browser. That's a little learning curve. It feels natural to me. Like now I totally get it. But I remember at first I was like kind of confused. I'm like, how do I change the color? So you click your fabric in the object browser, and then the property editor for the fabric will pop up and open. So texture is if you want to add a print, and that's something we're going to talk more about in the upcoming module. A normal map is like the texture of the fabric. So there's already a default one that CLO provided. If you get really into 3D, maybe you can find your own to add. They're so weird from my point of view, because you know, 3D is new to me. I'm more of a fashion person, and they're always like blue or purple. It's so weird, but it seems to work. You can also change the color in the property editor. There's a little box right here, and then you could pick a color. They have like different Pantone things. Sometimes I like to find this number, whatever that number's called. Like I might find that from, you know, Photoshop or Illustrator and just copy and paste it in, just so I have super control. But I mean, they do have like a shade and tint variation palette thing as well. But anyways, that's where you change the color. I'm just gonna say, okay. Yeah, if you wanna add a print, again, like I said, it's under texture, you hit those little four arrows that are kind of pointing at each other. There we go. And then it pops up and you can go find your print. It should be a PNG, maybe a JPEG's okay. Also, don't try to put it in an Illustrator file or Photoshop file. That's not gonna work. I recommend that it's a tile that's ready for repeat as well. Otherwise, else you're gonna get weird lines on it. Over here, they do have a whole editor, but again, we'll talk more about that next module when we get into prints. You probably just right now are just mostly gonna be concerned about color, I would say. I'd say even playing around the normal map is a little bit more advanced. I would just leave the default normal map, to be honest. Let's see here. It's kind of fun. They have like other things that you can change your fabric, like if you want it more rough or have more reflection. But again, all of this is set for the type of fabric. So if you're picking a satin, I would leave this reflection and roughness at the default because it's designed to be for satin. And same if it's a twill or denim or whatever. But you can change it a little bit if you really wanted to. Let's see here. That's, I think, the highlight of what I want to talk about is just, you know, you can name it, change the color, you can copy, you can add more, you click and drag and bring it here. And then anyways, to put it on your garment, you'd actually have to click and drag and drop it on your pattern pieces. Did I just add the belt fabric? So I just added the belt fabric to the pant leg. I'll bring the pant fabric back. Okay. So anyways, if you guys have questions, if I'm missing anything, if I didn't explain something, let me know. And I'd be happy to figure it out and help you guys along the way. All right.